Hello, and welcome back to Dark Souls Randomized. I have re-randomized the enemies, so let's see kind of where that gets us. I realized I forgot to pick up the Great Chaos Fireball that Petrus is holding on to. Should probably help. Okay, so that got replaced with the Black Knight, and that is replaced with the one of those guys. Black Knight's doable. I would prefer to take care of it on its own. Fuck. Okay, I don't know where that dog came from, but DLC dogs with more health than regular dogs. As long as we take it slow. And don't lose our cool. I think we'll make it out of this just fine. Now this dog's on me. Yeah, I wish it didn't take 5 hits to kill a dog. There's another dog over there too. Christ. The bone wheel. This is not a good area for that. Four-pronged plow. Even though it's clearly a pitchfork. What else is in here? It's one of those. The dog must have come from in here. So there's a dog. And a fire-breathing dog, and a bone wheel, and a skeleton totem. I don't know what those are called. Pillar of skulls, maybe. Yep. Spoiler, it's a crossover planescape. That's the true lore, the deep lore. What I really need to be careful of is not resting after I kill these things. Because that would undo all of my hard work. This Black Knight is very oblivious. Thank God. As while I eat Black Knights for breakfast, I'm wielding a fire weapon at the moment, which is not the best against them. In fact, it's the worst against them. They have some of the best fire resistance gear in the game. So we got a frog. Take that, Froggo. Got one of those. Although he seems content to sit in there. Let's see what's up here. Two dogs. And a serpent. Sorcerer. able to lure one out first. Always good. Just wanted to make sure that other guy didn't wake up. I think we're far enough away that we didn't trigger that guy. What's up here? Anything that's gonna come after me? You know what? Better to just take advantage of this while I have some peace. Okay. Bone wheel. Bone wheel. Great axes. Couple of bone wheels, eh? Oh, I see. Come from up here? No, there's a Berenike Knight up here. But I don't think he can come through that door, so I think I'm safe. Well, those bone wheels are doing their thing. I guess I'll see what this is up here. Seeing as it's just a little bitty rat. It's a little proud knight. Nice. Never complain about a soul item. There was a second one, though. I wonder where it went. White Titanite chunk. Oh, it went down there. That's fine with me. Let's go see what we have for Taurus now. Hopefully not Gwyn. Nito. Alright. Nito's a bit more manageable than Gwyn. Okay, these things. Okay, Nito's probably still gonna be kinda tough. Because he's a late game boss. But I think I can do it. So I wanna top off. Want to do Power Within. Far away for that attack. Oh shit, he teleports, that's right. This is just gonna walk right off the edge. That'll be something. What's he doing? I think that's supposed to be his teleport move. Whatever, not looking this gift horse in the mouth. Now he's facing away from me, so I can't hit him like that. Come on. Come on, buddy, we were fighting, it was fun. Oh, there we go. He's like floating. Yeah, this thing just does not do much damage. This might seem lame to you, sorry about that. Me, I'm just happy to make some forward progress. I don't think I've had a randomizer run this bad before. Where I'm this kind of up against the wall. And also don't doubt that I would have been able to beat Nito in a straight up fight. It is cool just getting to see his model and stuff like that, like these weird bone legs. Yeah, the smoky cape and all that, it's just good. It's good stuff. Keep on hammering away. I would love to get the Gravelord sword. That's one that is another speedrun weapon. It's one that everybody else seems to find in the randomizer pretty easily, but I just have not. Did it. One more bone, humanity. Nothing more interesting than that, eh? Okay. More miracles, which I don't want or need. Talk to Solaire, see how he's dressed, too. Oh.
Ah, hello. You don't look high.
Interesting get-up, friend.
Oh, I... The way I can... This pleases... We are the black two-time of
the, like, muffled tone of his voice. I don't know. That feels way different when, like... Something just died. Oh, the muffling, I don't know, it just feels different when it's not, you know, a helmet, and instead it's the horrible head of a corrupted townsperson from Lulisiel. Don't love the clam over there. Clams are no joke. Clam chowder. How did that get there? Who even knows? Will this be enough? Maybe. I didn't pay attention to the numbers. Yes, it is enough. Okay, I only need 4 more levels before I can wield the Demon Great Axe. Really hope that I can find Havel's Ring or the Ring of the Wolf so I can have some poise or some heavier armor or something, at least. I gotta have something to go with the super heavy-ass weapon. I don't think it worked. Nice. Oh shit, there it is. Fuck. Yeah, I used up all of my black fire bombs. Okay. I guess this thing is spazzing out, so. Oh, there it goes, though. What's going on here? Where it cannot follow. God, this range. Killing me. Yeah, I really can't wait until I find a weapon that works. Maybe this thing will drop a Twinkling Titanite, though. Probably won't, though. That's only in the base game that it would do that. Randomize crap. Ooh, okay. That was close. Not that I, like, have to go back super far or anything like that. But it'd be nice if I didn't have to go back. Would be nice. I'm sure this is thrilling to watch. Sorry about this. I suppose I could have just quit out and reloaded, and it would have been back in its spawn place, far enough away from the bonfire for me to rest. But now I really feel like I own this victory, so. I have a homeward bone. Another thing I gotta find at a merchant. Okay, so I started up this way. Actually, I came the back way. It didn't go so great. Get the fuck back here. Fine, I'll go up here.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
It's not your fault, Eggburden. Know if there are any items down here, but I have the poison block shield, so even though, as I have to keep reminding myself, there won't be rats down here. It is randomized. It's been randomized the whole time. Unless it's on the area out there, I guess I'll check. Might as well, since I'm here. Awesome. Ooh, you. Big boy. Family is a football team. Okay, so yeah, nothing down here as it turns out. I couldn't remember. It's been probably since like my first time playing Dark Souls that I actually went through this area. Before I figured out how to get past the Drake. Ooh, hello. No. I just don't want to deal with clams sometimes, you know? Fucking clams. Where did that clam come from? I hope it didn't come from out this way. But it probably did. I'd guess. There's a frog. No clams. Not yet, anyway. Clams? Clam chowder. Shot at us. No items up here. No. I took the one that was up here. There's an item down there. Heard a sound. Can't believe I dodged that. I slowly and methodically make our way through this. He's gonna run away. Egbert and smash it. Something over there. Oh good, another one of those. Jeez. Do I have anything? I guess I should try using the alluring skull, maybe. Hey, everybody, come over here. Oh my god. Oh shit. Oh shit. I don't... Oh fuck. That does so much damage. I don't know if I can fight that thing. I need something to kinda wave it off. This sucks, but it's the only way to be safe. Way too strong. Way too much health. And Vamos's hammer just does not have enough range. Shit. Bone wheel. I can handle that. This will be a key, which I don't actually need. No one actually needs to save Lautrec. It's a weird thing where no matter what, Lautrec is always free after you've beaten the gargoyles, even if you didn't free them. I've never really been able to understand why that is, but it is the case. Oh shit, there's a basilisk. Okay. Ooh, the greatsword, nice. I've not used that to any great effect. I usually go with the Zweihander, because it's much easier to get, and you can get a lot earlier. And it's got that pancaking move, which just... pancakes. I'm not even a big pancake guy in real life, but... I love pancaking enemies. Alright. This is so much smoother. At the risk of jinxing everything for the rest of my life. Oh, that's the sound that I heard. Okay, at least we haven't been running into any chained prisoners. That's been pretty lucky. We saw that one down in New Londo when we swung by. Okay, big mushroom. Don't want to fight. What do we have over here? Crystal Archer. Don't want to fight, but is doable. And you don't want to fight, but we're gonna fight anyway. think I got the key from down there. I guess I could check really quick. Basement key. Yep, got it. So, at this point, let's run down to Andre and regroup. I can take on this Berenike Knight. Thanks for the Titanite Shard. Rest. And then I don't remember. Ooh, I got the Soul of Priscilla. Let's see how many souls that's worth. Okay. I need two more levels. And then I can use the Demon Great Axe. I do wish you could try out the movesets on weapons in Dark Souls 1 if you don't have the strength for them. That became kind of a thing as the series went on, that you could just do the movesets but do them really shittily for like no damage. But in this, you get a goofy, like, I'm such a weakling swing. So you don't really get to see what it's like. No, I don't want that. I want that. Okay. I just really like the Lord's Blade armor. I'd like to wear that eventually. Okay. Well, let's call it here for now, and then hopefully next episode we can make some headway into fighting the gargoyles and stuff like that, and we can move on to Lower Undead Burg, if time allows. But I will see you guys next time. Bye!